today we are going to review the Dyson PureCool air purifier. First we are going to take a look at its features and then we will test how quick and efficiently it can purify the air in a room. First, how it works. The motor inside sucks in air through the side vents and then it passes through the 360 degree glass HEPA filter, which can purify up to 99.95% of particle matter up to 0.1 micron. Then it passes through the TRIS-coated activated carbon filter where the odors are captured. These filters are vacuum sealed in such a way that none of the captured particles escape back to the surroundings. The purified air is then pushed out through the vent at top and the multiplier effect helps throughout powerful air current. Dyson PureCool comes with a small, elegant magnetized remote control and you can keep it on top of the air purifier. You can also control the air purifier using the Dyson Link app. You can control the airflow speed. It can be controlled from level 10 and it goes up to 1, that is the maximum and the minimum. And then you have the oscillation, you can set from off to 350 degree. So it is off 45, 90, 350 degree, so on whatever you want, you can set it depending on how people are located in the room. And then you have the timer function, which can be set from 15 minutes up to 9 hours. And you have the auto mode and night mode, which reduces the sound of the air purifier. The airflow level will also be lower. And then the airflow direction, which is basically how the airflow is diffused. And now the LED display on the air purifier shows various air quality parameters. Green is for good, yellow is for moderate, orange is poor, and red is very poor. And you also have violet for severe. In the LED, you can see the VOC, NO2 level, temperature, humidity, the filter life, Wi-Fi network, the air quality index, 24-hour air quality index, then the PM2.5 level, PM10 level. That is pretty much it. Now let's test how it performs. We are trying it out in a rather small bedroom of just about 150 square feet space. But it can be used for spaces as large as 600 square feet. So we live in a place which is not that polluted. So we have to artificially increase the PM levels by lighting up to Agarbatti. So I think 2 will suffice as it's a rather small area. And after it's completely burnt, we'll check the air quality with a monitor. As you can see, the PM 2.5 and 10 levels have gradually increasing and it is finally stabilized at around 104 and 120. So we switched on the Dyson PureCool air purifier and have put it in auto mode so that the airspeed is adjusted as per the pollution level. And it's indeed quite fast and you do hear a visible, you do hear the noise. Now, as you can see, the air quality is very poor. It is in red level. So we are also setting the oscillation 350 degree for maximum efficiency so that air is sucked in and thrown out in all directions. And we are going to note the PM levels at few intervals. Now, after about 12 minutes or so, the PM levels have gone down drastically. Now, the PM 2.5 is 42 and PM 10 is 48. And VOC has also gone down almost half and it is going down by the second. Now after 15 minutes, the PM 2.5 is 34 and PM 10 is 39. Now after 30 minutes, it has completely come down to 21 and 24, which is pretty much back to normal. So now I have shot this video after about 1 month of use. You can see the HEPA filter. It has captured a lot of minute dust, but just look at the other side and it is just as good as new. This is because the HEPA filter is fixed down to the structure in such a way that it is completely vacuum sealed and only clean air passes through the activated carbon filter. So overall, this unit is fairly efficient, but then structure-wise, it is a bit prone to falling, and of course, the unit is quite expensive too. But otherwise, it's a fairly good option, especially for those living in Delhi and such polluted cities. So that's it, friends. You can find the link to the purchasing in the description. Thanks for watching.